May 2014, a Russian expedition led by the researcher Alexander Koltypin was the first one to conduct on-field study of this remarkable archaeological remains located in the Phrygian Valley of nowadays Turkey, which consist of petrified vehicle tracks which were apparently imprinted in the that time soft stone or mud during the Neogene period. The other members of the expedition were Alexander Zhiharev, Andrei Kuznetsov and Anastasia Legutina. And this is the first presentation of their research, or any research as a matter of fact, on this archaeological location in English. And I decided it's absolutely fascinating and unique information and deserves to be presented in, to the English-speaking public. The sources are Russian articles, and I have provided a link to them in the description of this video. First of all, I will start with a short overview of the dating techniques which were used to date these tracks to such an amazing faraway period in time, which is millions of years ago. And obviously we are talking about vehicle tracks. You can see it for yourself on the footage. So first of all, it's overview of the dating data. Second of all, I will review some other hypotheses that could arise in some people's minds as of the origins of the tracks, like for example, they could be left by heavy equipment trucks in recent times. Next, I will review in detail why the hypothesis that is given by the official historians that these are actually cart tracks which date some just a couple of thousand years ago, left by the animal-driven carts of the primitive people inhabiting those regions at that time. So I will point quite a few independent reasons which are sufficient by themselves to refute this hypothesis that it's possible that these tracks were left by cattle carts in the very recent history. And at the end, maybe I will try to give some clues of whose vehicles, not clues, but ideas about whose vehicles could have left those tracks millions of years ago. Okay, now let's mark one very important point that will be very useful in the further explanations. Please note how the various tracks cross each other, how they overlap each other, and also how well the tires were, or whatever, the wheels are printed in the earth. It is really obvious that when these tracks were made, it was soft, the earth was soft. It was either mud or the stone was still soft at the time that it was being formed. Please also pay attention, sometimes scratches will appear on the sides of the track, and this will also very well prove that the substance was soft when these vehicles passed on the surface and left these tracks. If these tracks were made when the stone was already hardened, they they would leave cracks all over, the full surface would be crushed, and the tracks wouldn't be so smooth. Also, pay attention to the very bottom of the tracks. It is very, very smooth. It is absolutely obvious that it was left just by one vehicle that passed there one time. Okay, sometimes two or more tracks meet each other, and then we can see how they overlap, and the result is same as if the two or three cars passed on a soft muddy surface one after another. I mean, this is really quite obvious from the footage. So apparently these tracks were made when the surface's gear was still soft. And how is that possible? Well, actually, given in consideration the volcanic activity in this area, that would have been earliest 5 million years ago. And when a proper study is done, you can see the footnotes for all the sources that Alexander Koltypin, whose specialty, by the way, is geology, of all the sources he has on the geology of the surface of Turkey, he reaches the conclusion that it has been some 5.3 million years ago, and through 23 million years ago. This is the time span in which this rock could have been formed due to volcanic activity. We don't know exactly, this is quite a long period of time, but somewhere within that time span, these rocks were formed, and they were soft enough for the vehicles to make this type of tracks in them. A further proof that we are really dealing with very, very old fossilized tracks is the erosion that is left on the surface and on the tracks themselves. There is clearly visible very thick crust that definitely takes a couple of millions years to form, and the crust is absolutely consistent. It is same all over the area where the tracks are left. It is same on near the tracks. It is same on the tracks themselves. It's absolutely impossible for such a crust to form within 2-3,000 years, as it is suggested by the official archaeological data, so to say, on this archaeological site. Although nobody has done any research at all, still they somehow labeled it to be very, very recent, just because they label everything to be very recent by default. But the crust is definitely a very tangible proof of the absolutely amazing ancient time when these tracks were formed. You can find the full chemical analysis of the crust on the website of Alexander Koltypin, a link provided in the description of this video. Another point, as I mentioned briefly before, proving that we are dealing with a very, very ancient site, is the fact that if it was made in recent times, the sides of the tracks would have been crushed by the repeated usage of vehicles. We don't see that at all. The tracks are absolutely smooth. They haven't been used after that. There is no other sign of wear. It is clearly visible that they were made and they got fossilized. Another point worth mentioning now is that these tracks are only visible on the places where the rock that has been formed during the Neogene period is laid bare and it's visible. at some places where there are other layers of the earth visible on the surface, there are no tracks at all. And this is another absolute proof of the very ancient nature of these tracks. Other point to consider is the heavy erosion on the rocks, which is absolutely consistent with their Neogene period age of formation. They definitely show signs of wear due to weather that takes millions of years to form. And another point is that tracks are also subjected to this erosion. Obviously, the rock and the tracks were aging at the same time. If the tracks were some sort of recent formation, the erosion wouldn't have been visible on them. Same as the crust. Both things take millions of years to form. Actually, the tracks appear so well printed in the rock that it may cross somebody's mind, so what if recent very, very heavy vehicles left this track? Is this possible? Well, first of all, given the hardness of the stone, although it is tuff stone, or tuff, I'm not sure how it is in English, which is a relatively soft stone, still it is a stone, and currently there is no vehicle in our civilization, at least, that is able to leave such a... Or if they were passing repeatedly to form the tracks, I mean, the logic is that if there is no such a heavy vehicle that can do it at once, so what if they passed many, many times? That also doesn't fit what we see on the ground, because if that was the case, the tracks wouldn't be so so nicely visible. All around them would be crushed, and they wouldn't be with such a smooth sides and corners as we see actually on the ground in reality. Although no archaeologist in the past did a proper study of the tracks, still, they already know without studying them how were the tracks made, and they have an official version, as they have for everything. And here the version is that the tribes that were inhabiting this area some 2,000-3,000 years ago, they made these roads, they called them roads, with their animal carts. And when the carts would use the same track again and again, it would get deeper and deeper, the stone would crush deeper and deeper under the wheels of the carts, and a track would be formed. And when it gets too deep, then they would move a little bit on the side, and then another track would be formed. Isn't it a miracle? It didn't happen anywhere else on earth, but it happened here. Apparently the stone was very soft. However, in reality, please see the picture that is now on the screen and look at the third position of the wheels. Obviously, we have had a very high-tech vehicle making these tracks, because when the surface wasn't even like in a position 3, still the tires wouldn't be tilted, like the surface where the tires touch the ground is still absolutely horizontal, because the device was manufactured in such a way to function in such a rough environment. If it was a simple horse or ox cart, we would have what you see on picture, in the middle picture, You know, the tires are tilted, they do not step on the ground horizontally. However, when the tracks were measured, it is obvious that the vehicles were well manufactured to suit the environment, and there would be some sort of springs or I don't know what sort of device, but something was keeping the tires to step still horizontally on the ground, and this is a definite proof that actually it was pretty well designed and sophisticated vehicles that left these tracks after all. The next point is that the official archaeology calls these tracks roads, but they're nowhere near roads. Actually, a road is something connecting two points. And these tracks, they're just all over the place. I mean, look at this aerial map that is now on the screen. They're practically going in all directions, all over the place, where the rocks that were formed during the Neogene periods show on the surface. Where something else shows on the surface, they're not present at all. This is one more proof, actually, that these were really roads or even tracks that were formed just a couple of thousand years ago. They would be visible on all types of surfaces, regardless of the age of the rock. They would be visible also on the rocks formed during other historic periods. However, there is not a single track that is visible on a rock that is not formed during the Neogene. Another point that roads, they always somehow consider the landscape around. I mean, when there is a difficult place to conquer, they will not go just exactly over the top of a mountain, they would go slightly around it. There is no such consideration with these tracks. They just go over hills where it's comfortable, where it's not comfortable, over cliffs, over bumps. It really doesn't matter. They're just all over and they have no direction and no consideration for the surroundings. So there is no question of any roads here at all. Another thing is that roads, even in the antiquity, would get repaired when they have a problem. And in this particular case, if the tracks that are supposedly left by these primitive carts were getting too deep and the road, so-called road, was getting useless, I mean, it wouldn't be very difficult to just get a bucket or just even a broom and sweep pebbles that are readily available all around and continue using the road instead of making a next track. However, we see no attempt at all to fill up the tracks and reuse the road. Basically, there are no signs of any attempts to repair the roads, and roads are repaired. That's why they're made and maintained. Well, and that takes us straight to the next point. Actually, roads are usually built. And here, there is no sign of building anything. Okay, on the flat surface where we have just flat rock, obviously there is no point in building a road over there. However, we can see that after a few meters, this flat stone surface meets a muddy area. And over there, if this was really a road, there would have been some sort of enforcement of the surface to make a road. I mean, just imagine if a vehicle was that heavy and enormous to make track in hard stones, how would it behave in the mud? Obviously, there is no question of any roads here. There is no building. There could have been some wooden, there would have been some sort of wooden support or even just pebbles, anything. It could be primitive to look like a road, but this doesn't resemble a road even remotely. It is just a vast network of tracks all over the place. Another point is that if these tracks were left gradually by a large number of animal pulled carts in the very recent history, by recent time in 2-3,000 years, then there would have been signs also in the middle where the supposed animals, poor animals who were dragging these heavy loads, would have passed. Actually, such signs are absolutely absent. Moreover, just look at this picture that is now on the screen. Look at this turn. I mean, the wheels of the vehicle were, it was going sideways. I mean, a cart would get stuck here. It's obvious the animals would damage their feet. They would break their legs trying to walk on such terrain. It's obviously absolutely impractical for any type of carts to use these so-called roads. Actually, other things got imprinted in the soft stone or soft mud, whatever the form was of the earth when these tracks were made. It was soft, and it was not only the tracks, other things got also imprinted in the soft surface. Pay attention to this quadratic or structures with regular corners. I wonder what would be the official historic explanation for such road formations. Maybe the kids of the people who were riding in the cars, they stopped over and they were they made these tracks with their tiny small carts by moving them in such a fashion over a small place. That must be the explanation in that type of spirit of explaining. At few locations, there were observed tracks of something that would resemble, I don't know, a motorcycle or bicycle, because it was just a single track. There were no two tires. So apparently there were different types of vehicles also. And by the way, Turkey is not the only location where such or similar tracks are observed. And as it can be expected, it is always on similar rocks that were formed during the Neogen period. And other locations where such imprints can be found, although not in such abundance, are Bulgaria, which borders Turkey, Azerbaijan, Abkhazia, Armenia, and Crimea, as well Mexico and US. Maybe some listeners are a bit confused about all these tracks left by vehicles that seem to be high-tech and all that some 5 to 23 million of years ago, when we were supposed to be some sort of monkey-like creatures, according to what they taught in school. Well, this is not at all a mystery. And these findings are absolutely coherent with many other modern findings in archaeology, and not so modern. It was quite a few years ago that Michael Kremer combined his brilliant work, where he, with remarkable precision, describes and gives complete footnotes of hundreds of objects that confirm intelligent presence on Earth for millions and millions of years ago. Such findings are, they number in hundreds or even thousands, and none of them are very new. Just those of you who feel confused, the reason is that this type of archaeological findings are not included in history textbooks, standard history textbooks in any country of the world. simply because it doesn't fit the official picture as they try to present it to people, whatever agenda they have. And if you have enjoyed this video and you find it fascinating, you can also find another similar mind-opening video about Cappadocia on my channel. And of course, I already mentioned the work of Michael Cremon, where you can make yourself familiar with findings about intelligent existence millions of years ago. So again, having tracks of sophisticated vehicles dating 5 to 23 millions ago is not some mystery. It's absolutely coherent with hundreds of other findings of all sorts and descriptions made by archaeologists all over the world. And if you're still having difficulty to adjust your mind to the wavelength of having high-tech vehicles during the Neogene period, when monkeys were roaming the face of the earth, I promised you in the beginning to give you a hint of what kind of monkeys could have operated these vehicles. Or I don't know, they could have been robots as well, or coming from other locations, not Earth. I really have no clue about that. But I would advise you to visit a wonderful website called Descent from Darwin. A link can be found in the description of this video. And this will explain a lot to you. It will explain why they taught you in school that scientists think that we evolved gradually from monkeys or whatever ape-like creatures and so on and so on. Just they didn't mention that it is some scientists that think that. It is not all. They forgot to mention to you, unfortunately, that there are many other theories, hypotheses, same like the new Darwinism is just a hypothesis about the origin of our and other species. It is not something that is proven already, same like the many other hypotheses that exist around. And on this website, you will be surprised to find out that actually it is not accepted all across the scientific community that this type of natural evolution is solely responsible for the variety of species that exist currently on our planet. And another small reminder I would like to make is that in the same way as currently on the planet we have practically different civilizations of humans living in, on one side you have uncontacted tribes that still live their lives in a caveman style. Although they are not the majority, they still exist. They don't know anything about the world the way we know it. And then we have our technologically relatively advanced society, and we exist parallel with each other, and one of the parties doesn't even know about the existence of the other party. So if this is possible nowadays, why it wouldn't have been possible during the Neogene period? Maybe at that time, the ratio was different. The ratio is even changing nowadays constantly between the so-called civilized and non-civilized population on Earth, although those terms are not extremely appropriate in this situation. But anyway, so if this is possible now, why it wouldn't have been possible at that time? And that would explain all. Why there are lots of archaeological findings of caveman lifestyle of humans, and along with them there are plenty of findings that suggest highly evolved beings with technological knowledge and technological abilities that even surpass our own. So yes, thank you for listening, and hope this has broadened your perspective about who are we, the humans.